Hi! Welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to learn how to play the game called Minesweeper. I will share to you easy tips to pass this game. This is the Minesweeper map. This one is a 9x9 dimension. On the right side is the timer and the number of mines present. The first step is to open a hole in the map. Choose a square to click. I will choose the middle part. And it opened a big space. Please note that your first click will not open a mine. Let's start with the red area that has number 1 in the center. The number indicates a mine in its perimeter. For example, the number 1 tells us that there is one mine around it. There is only one square not open, so it is a mine. To mark a mine, put a flag on it by right-clicking the square. The next area has number 1 at the center. It is already cleared since one flag is present in the area. So the remaining square is safe to open. For the next area, the number is 2. There are 2 mines around it, and there is just one flag present. So we need one more to clear this area. There is one square not opened, and should be considered a mine. This is same to the next area with number 3. We mark the remaining square to satisfy the number of mines in this area. Do the same with this next area of 4 mines. We should mark 2 mines to clear this area. In this area, there are already 4 flags or mines present, so the other square is safe to open. Same with this area. This area has 3 mines. So this blue square will be marked as mine to clear the area. This area is already cleared by the one flag, so it is safe to open the other square. As of now, you have familiarized this common pattern of mine position already. In this area, number 2 is already satisfied, so we can now open the other square. Again, this common pattern is very helpful in marking the mines. This area of 1 is already satisfied, so the remaining square is not a mine. Again, another common pattern for number 1. Number 2 is already satisfied, so we can open the remaining squares. Now there are 4 squares left to open. It may seem difficult to pinpoint the mine. But there is a way to do this. Take note of the number of mines remaining. There is only 1. We can see that this area needs at least 1 mine to satisfy the number 3. We can conclude that the other 2 squares outside this area are safe to open. We can now clear the remaining squares. This area with number 3 is already satisfied, so this one last square is safe to open. Congratulations! Here is a sample of an accomplished 16x16 map for your reference. Choose a starting point that is convenient for you. Keep using the red square area and spotting the mines to be able to familiarize with the common patterns. Slowly but surely check the mines and make sure to satisfy the numbers in each area. Enjoy the rest of this 16x16 map. Congratulations on your learnings. Practice makes perfect. You can set a goal to finish every map faster every time. Thank you for watching. If this has been informative to you, please subscribe to our channel to keep you updated with our next videos. Stay safe.